الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفوته من خلقه وحبيبه، قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وجاهد في سبيل دينه حتى أتاه اليقين. فاللهم اجزه عنا وعن والدينا وعن الإسلام والمسلمين خير ما جازيت به نبيا عن قومه ورسولا عن أمته. اللهم أحينا على سنته وآمتنا على ملته، واحشرنا تحت لوائه وأوردنا حوضه، واسقنا من يده الشريفة شربة هنيئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا. أما بعد، we are continuing and this most probably is a real last session on this topic. I found some stuff that I thought it would not be wise to deprive everybody from listening to this part. And it is a concluding session, inshallah, for this topic. Last time, the finale of the ayat talking about this issue, the issue of tafakkur and tadabbur, to ponder and think the Quran. Here is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taking us all the way to the Day of Judgment. This is ayah number 52, Surah Yunus, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ثُمَّ قِيلَ لِلَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا ذُوقُوا عَذَابَ الْخُلْدِ. It was then said to those wrongdoers, taste the torment of eternity. Very scary expression. Torment is very scary, but torment for eternity is really scary. So, as we have been saying all along, when Allah brings us a picture or image or situation from the hereafter, the ultimate purpose is to either entice us to do what we have to do or to stop us from doing what we need to quit. Here, it is the latter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to understand what the consequences are for not listening to Allah or ignoring His commands. And then the most tormenting statement is, هَلْ تُجْزَوْنَ إِلَّا بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَكْسِبُونَ. Are you not compensated for nothing but what you've been earning? Again, it reminds a person in that situation of what Allah has given him in his life and how he responded and how regrettable his position would be. But at that day, on that moment, regret is not going to be of any help. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from that situation. Then following, it goes back to addressing the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وَيَسْتَنْبِئُونَكَ أَحَقٌّ هُوَ. And they want you to foretell them, is this true? They are still in doubt. Is this true? Are we going to be tormented? Is there really hellfire? Is it going to be for eternity? Are we going to be reminded of the blessings Allah has given us? Are we going to be reminded of what we have earned, of sayyat and violations and everything? Is this true? And Allah tells the Prophet ﷺ, قُلْ إِي وَرَبِّي. Say, by Allah, it is true. It is not only true, it is the truth. And you are not going to escape from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you are not going to escape from hellfire. This is like closing the circle on a criminal in the court. But the real torment will come on the Day of Judgment. But it is tormenting for someone to live in violations, after violations, after violations, and to know what the end is like, and he doesn't even think to repent. Here is a chance. Over there is no chance. So this is what the Quran is trying to tell us. Think about it. Ponder that day. don't forget the day of judgment. You know that the day of judgment is the compass by which the Muslim lives. When your compass is running haywire, you don't know where the direction is. So your compass should be looking forward to that day and positioning yourself with your actions, which fate do you like more? And then adjust your behavior accordingly. This is what we need to be thinking of. Then on that day also, and if every soul who had wronged possessed all that is on the earth, it would use it as a ransom. Can you believe it? On that day, if you have everything there is on the earth in your position, it is all yours. On that day, people who wronged themselves in this life or wronged others, they would wish to give it all to ransom themselves. Is it a price worth paying to save your neck? Of course it is. But why don't you pay some in this life and get over there scot-free? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from that day. And then, وَأَسَرُّ النَّدَامَةَ لَمَّا رَأَوُ الْعَذَابِ. They concealed their regret. They cannot speak, they cannot complain, they cannot challenge what they are facing. وَقُضِيَ بَيْنَهُمْ بِالْقِسْطِ, and they have been judged with justice, and nobody, including even them, no one will be treated unjustly. Even those who are getting to hellfire, they will be asked, هَلْ تُجْزَوْنَ إِلَّا بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَكْسِبُونَ إِلَّا بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. And they will have to answer, haven't our messengers come to you with truth and clear evidence? They will say, yes. وَلَكِنْ حَقَّتْ كَلِمَةُ الْعَذَابِ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ. But the judgment against the disbelievers will come to pass. They will admit this on the day of judgment. So the time to think is here, not when we get over there. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asserts His dominion, control, and power. أَلَا إِنَّ لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Indeed, everything, whatever is in heavens and in the earth, all of it belongs to Allah. Which means what? You own nothing. You control nothing. You yourself are in the hands of Allah. He does what He wills. And whether you like it or not, you have to live with it. Why does the Quran extract completely every resource and every power from the hands of the creature that Allah has empowered over all creatures? Because with all the power He gave, He expects some gratitude. At least don't deny Him. At least don't deny Allah. At least don't deny His commands. The minimum is to believe and submit. أَلَا إِنَّ لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. أَلَا إِنَّ وَعْدَ اللَّهِ حَقِّ. Indeed, the promise of Allah will come to pass. It is true. Whatever He promises, it happens. Whether you relate it or you don't, whether you recognize it or you don't, whatever Allah promises, it happens. One of the things I love to go to is the promises that Allah has given us, and they came to pass in this life. Why? Because you can't deny it. The fact is there, the actuality is there, things have come to pass, you've seen it with your own eyes. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that وَكَمْ مِنْ قَرْيَةٍ كَانَتْ ظَالِمَةٍ. How many times a village, a town, a country, a nation lived doing nothing but wrongdoing. They just do injustice. They just want to enrich themselves and their people. They don't care about others. فَأَخَذْتُهَا وَإِلَيَّ الْمَصِيرِ. And I have taken them out, and to me belongs all their fates. Everybody will face an individual fate based on his or her actions. But collectively, we will have to face the fate of our collective action. That's why the Amr bil Ma'ruf and the Nahi an Munkar are essential, because this is the only way to clean the society from wrongdoers, by helping them, rehabilitating them, because they need rehabilitation. So we have seen the example of the Soviet Union in 1979 and 80s, running over a very poor, very primitive nation, but believing and powerful believers were there to stand. And they stood for quite a long time. Many of us have lived this period watching every day what is going on, until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala broke down the entirety of the Soviet Union. Have we not seen this? Isn't this a good example? Before that, where is Britain today that once was the empire on which the sun never sets? The sun never set. It did set. Where are the Romans? The Roman Empire. Where is the Persian Empire? Where is the Greek Empire? So these are true laws in application that show us the hands of Allah working according to His promise. No one after that should doubt the promises of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah asserts His power again. هو يحيي ويميت. What do people fear the most? All of us, Muslims and non-Muslims, we all fear death. We all fear death. But the believer knows that he is going to meet the one he has been worshipping for years. So even though he fears death, how it will go, but he is very optimistic to meet the merciful, compassionate God that he has been worshipping. And it's fully different from someone who has been promised not only death, but death followed with torment. It's a huge difference. So Allah is telling us, it is He who gives death, it is He who gives life. Be mindful. If you're afraid for your life, go to Allah. If you're afraid for your children, go to Allah. If you're afraid for your fate, go to Allah. There is no escape away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You can't run away. Where do you go? Ayn al-mafar. Where is your escape? There is no escape. And to Him you shall all return. Very powerful also. You can run, but you cannot hide. Then, Ya أيها الناس, O mankind, قد جاءتكم موعظة من ربكم. There has been a good advice and admonishment that has come to you from Allah. Whom is Allah talking to now? He's talking to the entire humanity. What is He telling us? After He asserted His authority, after He extracted all the power out of our hand to render us helpless and as weak as it can get, He's telling us, Allah has given you advice. Listen. Listen to His advice. Listen to His word. Follow His book. Follow His prophet. Not only advice, but وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ. Shifa is not treatment. Shifa is cure. Cure means it takes care of all the diseases of the heart, of the soul, of the mind. It takes care of everything that runs inside your chest. That's why it's called shifa'un lima fi al-sudur. Whatever is in your heart will be cured. And in our heart, there is a lot of struggle. We are fighting with ourselves to keep ourselves on the straight path. This fight will never end until we die. So you have to be alert. Don't give up your weapons. And don't say it is difficult. Difficult or not, it is your task. We have been created and put on this earth to overcome those temptations and struggle that our souls want to pull us for. وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. It has guidance and mercy for the believers. قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا هُوَ خَيْرٌ مِّمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. It's an amazing statement. Think about it. Think of what you're listening to. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, say, O Muhammad, in the bounties of Allah and in His mercy, let them rejoice only in this. This is what your rejoicing in this life must be for. No matter how broke you may be, no matter how bad your health is, no matter how difficult your situation may be, if you still have your faith, if you're still working for the mercy of Allah, no matter what happens to you, rejoice in the mercy and the love and the bounties of Allah. Sometimes we only count the bounties we do not have because we like to be sad and victims, unfortunately. That's a human nature. And we forget all the bounties that we have in our hand. But Allah is saying, let them count those bounties. Let them factor it in their calculus. فَبِذَٰلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا. What should we rejoice for? The mercy of Allah and His guidance. What is it worth? At least it is better than all what we collect and gather and pile up. قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ مِنْ رِزْقٍ. Have you considered the rizq, the provisions that Allah has given you? فَجَعَلْتُمْ مِنْهُ حَرَامًا وَحَلَالًا. You've divided it into your own set of what is haram and what is halal. Many Muslims, out of mostly ignorance, they think that something that is said clearly to be haram in the Quran, a sheikh could refabricate it, reformat it to make it halal. So we keep asking for fatwa until we get the sheikh we like. That is true. Especially when we are striving with someone else. Whether someone took your money, whether it is your wife or husband or a child you're fighting with, it becomes even more severe. The closest the person comes to you in kin, the more severe the fight is, which is the opposite. Allah says, Al-Aqrabun awla bil ma'roof. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, it is better to go to bed when you are treated unjustly to be the victim rather than the perpetrator. أن تنام مظلوما خيرا من أن تنام ظالما. You better be the victim in this life. Not that you don't seek your rights, seek it with all force. You are required. ما ضاع حق وراءه مطالب. But if the justice system fails you, if the society fails you, do you want to kill yourself or kill your adversary? Of course not. Be wise. There is a day that's called يوم التغابن, the day of claiming. You submit your claim and your victims will submit their claims. So you may be a victim, but you may be a perpetrator against others. So some people may wrong you, but look for the people that you wronged, because their claim will hurt you. But your claim against others is something you control. But you can't control that somebody will not complain against you. It's called يوم التغابن, the day of judgment, where you submit your complaints and your adversaries and victims will submit their complaint, and then your wife or husband will come and say, what she says, Allah, is wrong. You know that. But Allah will be the judge. He doesn't need explanation. He will not need your explanation. He knows everything. And on the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will invite and say, you, the wrongdoer, the perpetrator, do not speak. Stand up and be silent. And you, the victim, come forward. Because this is the day of the victims. So when whatever happens in this life of war effects, children being killed, women being killed, innocent people being killed, all of these are victims of the perpetrators. Those perpetrators, when they act in ultimate arrogance in this life, absolutely they don't have the day of judgment in their calculus. They don't. You remember warmongers, when it was the war on Iraq, the invasion of Iraq, and they were very happy, or the invasion of Pakistan, of Afghanistan, they were very arrogant. But don't forget, on that day, they will not have the chance to even talk. They will not. So you made something haram and halal based on your own desires, whims, and perceived and false interest, right? Then Allah says, say, did Allah permit you to do that? Did Allah give you part of His authority? The only one who can make something, designate something as haram or halal, is Allah and His messenger. That's the only thing. So people who refuse to accept the authority of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, while he himself says, أَلَا إِنَّمَا حَرَّمَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ كَمَا حَرَّمَ اللَّهِ. Indeed, whatever the messenger made haram, it is as is Allah made, as if Allah has made it haram. It's the same. But some people still, they don't want to follow the sunnah. And they think because they are smarter than everybody else. They are not. أَمْ عَلَى اللَّهِ تَفْتَرُونَ. Or are you fabricating lies on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Then وَمَا ظَنُّ الَّذِينَ يَفْتَرُونَ عَلَى اللَّهِ الْكَذِبَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. What do people who have fabricated lies on Allah think on the day of judgment? It's a question. Think about it. What do they think Allah will do to them? What do they think, how to explain themselves, if even allowed? And they are not going to be allowed. They will be rebuked and doomed on the spot. قال اخسأوا فيها ولا تكلمون. Stay put right there in hellfire and don't talk to me. Finished. The matter is finished. There is no discussion. And they call on the angel of hellfire and tell him, could you please call on Allah to give us respite? Says, haven't your messengers come to you and told you where the truth is? They say, yes. He says, stay put. Stay where you are. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَذُو فَضْلٍ عَلَى النَّاسِ. Allah has lots of bounties that He bestowed upon people, but the majority of people do not offer gratitude. People are rebellious. Against whom? The one who blessed them with everything. وَمَا تَكُونُ فِي شَأْنٍ وَمَا تَتْلُو مِنْهُ مِنْ قُرْآنٍ وَلَا تَعْمَلُونَ مِنْ عَمَلٍ إِلَّا كُنَّا عَلَيْكُمْ شُهُودًا إِذْ تُفِيضُونَ فِيهِ. Think about this when you see somebody weaker than you are and you're tempted to wrong that person, ask yourself, who's watching? Who is the witness over whatever crime or violation you want to have? It's Allah. إِلَّا كُنَّا عَلَيْكُمْ شُهُودًا إِذْ تُفِيضُونَ فِيهِ. As you are engaged in wrongdoing, Allah is not only watching, listening, and seeing, He is recording you. And you will come to receive these open books on the Day of Judgment. May Allah save us from that day. Then to make the matter clear, وَمَا يَعَزُوبُ عَنْ رَبِّكَ مِنْ مِثْقَالِ ذَرَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فِي السَّمَاءِ وَلَا أَصْغَرَ مِنْ ذَٰلِكَ وَلَا أَكْبَرَ إِلَّا فِي كِتَابٍ مُبِينٍ. Not an atom's weight of anything skips Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He captures every second of your life and even less. And before you run the tape with your own action, Allah knows what is in your chest, even before you talk, before you act. And nothing will escape Him. He captured everything. Then to give comfort to the believers after showing all of these horrible situations, أَلَا إِنَّ أَوْلِيَاءَ اللَّهِ لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Indeed, the awliya of Allah are not going to have grief, nor are they going to be afraid. They fear nothing, and they shall not grieve. So the two most troubling emotions that we have in this life, the awliya are saved from them. Why don't they fear? Because they trust Allah. Why don't they grieve? Because they love Allah and they trust Allah to deliver them. So they do not fear for what is coming. They only fear whatever wrong they have done. That's what they fear. They fear their own sins, not something happening to them. Because if something is planned to happen to you, it will happen whether you fear it or not. So, and they do not have grief over whatever they lose. You lost a son, Allah can give you another son. You lost a husband or wife, Allah can replace you. But these are not the things we should be afraid or have fear over or concerns or worries. We should only worry about our sins, because those require corrections in this life before we head back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who are awliyaullah? Awliyaullah, alladhina amanu wa kanu yattaqoon. Those who believed and they used to live a life of observance to Allah's rules. They were watchful for Allah, watching over them and watching them. So watching over them, it means He will take care of you. Watching you means He is recording what you're doing, good or bad. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَكَانُوا يَتَّقُونَ. To live a mindful life where you are mindful of Allah, you are alert to what you want to do, you're alert to what happens as consequences, then you are among awliyaullah. لَهُمُ الْبُشْرَى فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. They have the good promises in this life and in the hereafter. لَا تَبْدِيلَ لِكَلِمَاتِ اللَّهِ. No one will change the rules, the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever He says, He does. And it will happen, it will come to pass. Some people use this to say, why do you Muslims say that the scriptures before the Quran were changed? When your Quran says, لا تبديل لكلمات الله, which means no one can change the words of Allah. How could you reconcile this? This was Kalamullah, right? You claim it was changed. Your book says, it is not possible for anyone to change the words of Allah. How come you claim they changed it? Well, because it is not the words of Allah. So they are able to change it because what they change is what they author. But whatever is the word of Allah, it still exists in those scriptures. You find the tawheed. You find the prohibition of shirk. You find the prohibition of killing. So all the rules that Allah has set for humanity are still there. So where are the changes? The changes are in some other issue. We'll talk about it later on. But because it is authored books, it is not books that were dictated by the Prophet, whether it is Moses or Isa or anyone else, it is written by people after these prophets had left life. So it's because it is not the word of Allah, it has been changed. وَلَا يَحْزُنْكَ قَوْلُهُمْ. Let us not waste our time with what people say. People will say, you are crooks, you are terrorists, you are awful, you are backward, you're not worth the life you have, all of this. لَا يَحْزُنْكَ قَوْلُهُمْ. Don't you grieve because of what they say. Which means what? If you believe in Allah, if you believe in the words of Allah, then you must trust Allah and trust His words. You will be the upper hand in this life and in the hereafter. وَأَنْتُمُ الْأَعْلَوْنَ إِن كُنْتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ. You are the upper hand if you are true believers. This is where the problem is. The question is not مَتَى نَصْرُ اللَّهِ. When does the victory of Allah come? The question is, do we deserve it? Are we the believers that Allah promised victory alongside the messengers? إِنَّا لَنَنْصُرُ رُسُلَنَا وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَيَوْمَ يَقُومُ الْأَشْهَادِ. You have two victories promised, but you have to meet the conditions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One more time. أَلَا إِنَّ لِلَّهِ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ. You remember the previous ayah? أَلَا إِنَّ لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Here it is مَنْ, which means whatever is on earth and whoever is on earth or heaven, Allah has them as His subjects. He does with them whatever He likes. وَمَا يَتَّبِعُ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ شُرَكَاءَ. Those who are calling partners other than Allah, they have no real partners. It's false. إِيَّ يَتَّبِعُونَ إِلَّا الظَّنِ. They only follow their conjecture. وَإِنْهُمْ إِلَّا يَخْرُصُونَ. And they are only fabricating lies on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the love of the Quran and the thinking about the Quran and the regard for the Day of Judgment and the regard and the respect and appreciation of His Majesty. Allahumma ameen. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيتك ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقوتنا ما أحييتنا واجعله الوارث منا واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا إلى النار مصيرنا وإذا أردت بقومنا فتنة فنجنا منها يا مولانا غير خزايا ولا مفتونين ولا مبدلين ولا مغيرين اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فستذكرون ما أقول لكم وأفوض أمري إلى الله إن الله بصير بالعباد وأقم الصلاة